Bonjour mesdames et messieurs, in this video I'm going to show you three different ways to correct perspective in your videos. So sometimes, you know, you're going very low and you're shooting up like this and the perspective is not working. And if you stand here, then I'm going to show you a really cool surprise. Let's do it!
Alright, so here's a few tricks on how to correct perspective. This is a photo I shot a few days ago in the San Marco Plaza in Venice, and look at the perspective, it's really bad. I really wanted to do like a frame in a frame, and let me show you a little bit better. If I open the shadow and if I boost the white, you can see what the photo looks like. I'm going to hold on the option key to make sure I don't boost the white too much. I'm still holding the option key to do my black point. And by the way, I have a really cool formula on Lightroom that you can see if you get my book. Read my book, The Natural Drama Formula. It's a 5-step process that works on any photo. Step number one is always about the exposure. So I'm trying to get exposure right. But you see, like, the perspective is really, really bad. So before we do the other step of the retouching, what can we do about the perspective? I want to show you, in case you don't know. So you got this transform panel here, and the one that I use 90% of the time is auto. You just click on auto and boom. You pray and usually get a pretty, pretty good result. So you know what? I'm going to right click and I'm going to create a virtual copy because we're going to compare the different methods. Then I'm going to go off again. And this time I'm going to use guided. So guided, the way guided works is you click here and you make a little line here saying, I want this wall to be straight. And then I want this wall to be straight. And boom. But you see how it stretches the photo a lot. So what you have to do then is you have to go, and that's really the first trick, is you have to go to aspect to give it back its aspect ratio, which is pretty good. And then the third trick I'm going to show you, I'm going to create another virtual copy. The third trick, which is the one I use the most of the time, is, let me put everything back, is first you play around with the rotate. Voila. And you make it until that this wall, like the way this wall is and the way this wall is, point to the same direction. Like it's that it's very sort of centered. You know, it's basically the same degree of inclination, the same degree of slope on both sides. Okay, and then here comes the magic. Then you use vertical to make it straight. And I often find that this method gives me the best result. Okay, I kind of like that. And again, let's go to aspect to stretch it a little bit so it looks more natural. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to crop this photo. I'm going to crop this photo in 4x5. Let's go 4x5, but X, the Instagram 4x5, which is about like this. If you press X, you can go from one to the other. Boom, I kind of like that. I'm going to copy the crop that I did. And I'm going to copy it here. So Command-Shift-Z, and you choose the crop, and then Command-V to copy the crop. Okay, it's not doing a good job, so I have to reposition it because that's fine. I'm going to try to position it kind of similar. And then I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to copy the crop and reposition it. I just want to compare. And then you select all three photos, and you press N on your keyboard to go into survey mode. And I think the last method, so that's auto here, that is using the guided lines, and that is using the method of first doing the rotation, and then the vertical, and then the aspect, okay? And then as a little bonus, I want to show you my natural drama formula, so I'm going to basically retouch this one. And the first thing that you do, once you've done the exposure, my step number two of this natural drama formula, and you can get the printed version of my book for free if you pay shipping and handling. And you can even get 2 weeks of my coaching for free. Link is under this video. So what you do here is, well, let's look at the white balance. I think it's a little too warm. So I'm going to make it a bit more blue. Maybe add a bit of magenta. I always do the white balance when I've done exposure. Step number three is refining colors. So what I usually do is I go here in the hue, saturation, and luminance. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to saturation. I want to desaturate a little bit the yellow. It's a little strong to me, just a little strong. And then that's basically all I'm going to do on this one. Then step number four is the dodge and burn. And this one, all I'm going to do is I'm going to take a brush. Now, when you use a brush, a little tip on the brush is make sure, I want to show you something. Make sure that the feather is 100% because let's say I want to darken something and my feather is not 100%, check this, look what's gonna happen. It's not gonna be, that's without any feather. And if I put a lot of feather, Look at the difference. It's already more subtle, but it's still too strong. So if you put feather and you lower the flow and density, now you're going to get a result that is much more subtle, okay? And that's what you want to use for dodge and burn. So I'm going to erase this and restart again. So let's use a brush. So feather all the way, flow and density, you know, like in the 70s. And then I'm going to use the auto mask on. Auto mask is really cool because check it out. If I don't use auto mask, and let's say I want to darken, which is what I want to do, darken the frame of the frame, what's going to happen is that it's going to darken the sky too. I don't want this. So I'm going to erase that and I'm going to use auto mask. And check this out. Auto mask is going to basically only put the brush on the wall. Isn't that crazy? Only on the wall and not on the sky, which is not what I want. I just want to dark because I really want to focus the attention on this. And for the bottom part here, I'm going to take the auto mask off. Just want to make a frame in a frame. I'm going to darken that. So check it out. Before the darkening, after the darkening. And pretty cool. I think now I would just want to maybe add even more brightness and a little bit more magenta maybe and a little bit more clarity. I never add clarity if there is a sky, if there is clouds, I mean, but there's no clouds. That's the before and that's the after. Check out my new book and I'll see you in another video.